Are you ready to start?
Yes.
We have 1 minute, I give.
Okay, 1 minute, okay. I prepare my doklad.
Let me tell a few words. Let me say a few words. Okay.
I prepare my doctor. I think my doctor. Yes?
Hi, Yoshihiro.
Okay.
Okay, it's perfect. Well, let us go further. And our next speaker, Professor Vagiv Guliyev. Title of the lecture is Characterization of Generalized Fractional Maximal and Integral Operators in Orlich and Generalized Orlich Mori Spaces on Carnot Groups. Please, Professor Guliyev, go ahead.
Okay, thank you very much. At first, I would like to thank the organizing committee, and in particular, Professor Karpetyans, who invited me online workshop with these plenary lectures. So, my talk about characterizations of generalized fractional maximal and fractional integral operators in Orlich and generalized Orlich Mori spaces on Carnot groups. Okay. Carnot groups appear in quantum physics and many parts of mathematics, including Fourier analysis, several complex variables, geometry, and topology. Analysis on the groups is also motivated by their role as the simplest and the most important model in the general theory of vector fields satisfying Hermander's condition. The simplex examples of the Carnot groups are Euclidean space Rn, Heisenberg group Hn, and Heisenberg type groups introduced by Kaplan. We show Kaplan monographs, works, and Bonfiglioli, Lancanelli, Uguzzoni monographs about stratified Lie. Carnot groups also called stratified Lie groups also. Stratified Lie groups and potential theory of their sublaplacians. Carnot groups form a natural habitat for extensions of many of the objects studied in Euclidean spaces and find applications in the study of strongly pseudo-convex domains in complex analysis, semi-classical analysis of quantum mechanics, control theory, probability theory of degenerate diffusion process, and others. The basic setting of our study is the given Carnot group, G of step M greater than one. This is a connected and simply connected stratified nilpotent Lie group whose Lie algebra G admits a stratification. G V1 decompose sums Vm and is generals generated via commutator by its first horizontal layer V1. Given a basis XE of V1, then X2, this is horizontal gradient of U, then this lens. And also G be a finite dimensional stratified nilpotent Lie algebra. Also would there is a direct sum vector space decomposition. Also, defined homogeneous dimension and deviation operator in stratified groups in that form. A very important prototype of the Carnot group is Heisenberg group state M equal to. This is example Heisenberg group defined that. And Heisenberg algebra basis given what basis Heisenberg algebra of the left invariant vector fields of Hessian is given by x1, x2, n, x2, n plus 1 in that form. So, since G is nilpotent, the exponential map is diffeomorphic from G onto G, which takes the basic measure on G to a B-invariant Hard measure dx on G. The group identity of G will be referred to as the origin and denoted by G. A homogeneous norm on G is a continuous function, and this properties. And also BXR, this is balls, center X, radius R. The maximal operator and the fractional maximal operator M alpha defined in that form. In the case alpha equals zero, M is the hard Hilbert maximal operator. Also consider fractional integral operator the following form. For a function or rho, let E rho be the generalized fractional integral operator. In the case rho R equal R power alpha, then E rho is the fractional integral operator E alpha. The talk is sort of give necessary and sufficient condition for the boundedness of the generalized fractional maximal operator and the generalized fractional integral operators in the orbits and the generalized orbit Morris spaces will be given. We assume that condition two. Also, conditions 3 and 4 assume in that form. Instead of this condition, we assume that that condition 5. If rho satisfies 3 or 4, then rho satisfies 5, condition 5. For example, was the following example very important? What rho satisfies this function, or rho satisfies 2 and 5, but fails 3 and 4. But say fails 3 and 4. Moreover, we give necessary and sufficient condition for the boundedness of E rho, not only on orbit spaces, but also on orbit Morris spaces of the third kind. Also, we define the generalized fractional maximal operator M rho. The following seven In the case rho equal 1, the m rho is the Hardy-Littlewood maximal operator. And the case rho r power alpha, then m rho is the usual fractional maximal operator denoted by m alpha. We give some necessary condition and some sufficient condition for the boundedness of m rho on orbits and orbit Morris spaces. First, we must define Young orbit spaces. For orbit spaces, we need definition Young function. This is Young function definition, and the condition if the set of Young functions such that phi r greater than zero and less than infinity will be denoted by Y. If phi in Y, the phi is absolutely continuous on every closed interval and bijective from zero axis to itself. Young function phi is said also delta 2 condition, defined as that form. And delta 2 condition. And number two condition, we also use both condition in our theorems. That phi Young function, the set L phi is called orbit spaces. Orbit spaces is a Banach space with respect to the Luxembourg norm. In the case phi r equal r power p, we get a orbit space equal Lebesgue space, Lp space. If in the case phi r equal z, that defines then L phi is L infinity. Also a weak orbit space defined as that form. Examples. The following examples very important. What is this? Lp, Lp logarithm L power alpha, and Lp equal exponential L beta. The following theorem is one of our main results and gives necessary and sufficient condition for the boundedness of the operator E rho from L phi to weak from one orbit to weak L psi orbit and strong L phi to L psi orbit space. Let phi psi be Young functions. Let rho satisfy the condition 2 and 5. Then the condition 8 is sufficient for the boundedness of E rho from L phi to weak L psi g. Moreover, if phi satisfies Nabla 2 condition, then the condition 8 is also sufficient for the boundedness of E rho from L phi to L psi. Second, about necessity. The condition 9 is necessary for the boundedness of E rho from L phi to weak L psi and from L phi to weak to L psi. Another condition 9 necessary for the weak and strong boundedness of L phi to L psi. Then we combine sufficient and necessity, we get the following necessity and sufficient property. Let rho satisfy the condition 2 and 5. Assume the condition, we may be what condition 10 may be called regularity condition. Then condition 9 is necessary and sufficient for the boneness of error from LFI to weak HC. Moreover, if phi satisfies NABLA 2 condition, then the condition 9 is necessary and sufficient for the boneness of error from LFI to HC. If we take in this theorem, take rho r equal r power alpha, we give necessary and sufficient conditions for the boneness of the operator E alpha from Lphi to weak H psi and from Lphi to H psi. What's the following corollary? Let alpha between 0 and q. Q is the homogeneous dimension. Phi psi be Young function and phi in Jeff class. Assume the condition holds. This condition also be called for E alpha regularity condition. The condition R power alpha is necessary and sufficient for the boneness of E alpha from Lphi to weak H psi. Moreover, if phi satisfies NABLA 2 condition, then this condition is necessary and sufficient for the boneness of E alpha from Lphi to H psi. This condition may be called the Sobolev condition, the Sobolev identity. We now for E alpha boneness Lp to Lq, necessary and sufficient condition is 1 over p minus 1 over q equal alpha over n. This is called Sobolev identity condition. This is analogous of that Sobolev identity condition. In the case if phi r equal r power p, psi r equal r power q, in this condition we get Sobolev identity condition. Okay, this corollary was proved in that paper. Published in 2019 years in this work paper. The following example is also very important. If theta and psi theta, we define that form, then the pair rho phi psi satisfies condition A 9 in the following. Okay. The following theorem about boundedness of Genesat fractional maximal operator on orbit space. Let phi psi be Young functions. Assume that rho is increasing and that function is decreasing. Then the condition 11 is necessary and sufficient for the boundedness of m rho from Lphi to weak epsilon. Moreover, if phi satisfied Nabla 2 conditions, then the condition 11 is necessary and sufficient for the abundance of embryo from L phi to L psi. Note that in the case G equal Rn, necessary and sufficient condition for the abundance of the operator E alpha from L phi to weak L psi and from L psi to weak to L, from L phi to L to L psi was proved in the paper published 2016. And the following corollary about necessary and sufficient condition for the bonus of the operator M alpha from L phi to weak L psi and from L phi to L psi. Let alpha between 0 and q, phi psi be Young functions and phi in a class. The condition we called Orlitz setting Sobolev condition. Sobolev condition Orlitz setting may be called is necessary and sufficient for the boundedness of M alpha from L phi to weak L psi. Moreover, if phi satisfies Nabla 2, the condition is necessary and sufficient for the boundedness of M alpha to L phi to L psi. Okay. About generalized Orlitz-Morris space of the third kind. Generalized Orlitz-Morris space, organization of Orlitz space and generalized Morris space. There are three versions of generalized Orlitz-Morris space: Nakai's, Galas-Sabana-Tanaka's, and Deringer's Wurier-Samkov versions. We define the generalized Orlitz-Morris space of the third kind, which published in 2014. Note that the definition of the space of the third kind relies only on the fact that L phi is a normal linear space, which is independent of the condition that it is generated by modulars. The definition of generalized Orlitz-Morris space of the third kind as the follows. Let phi be a positive measurable function on the axis 0 infinity and phi any Young function. We denote by m phi 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 the generalized Orlitz-Morris space of the third kind, the space of all functions f phi local g with a finite norm. Also, the weak generalized Orlitz-Morris space we denote we define the following form. Okay, a function p is said to be almost increasing if the exist constant c satisfies this inequality, and also so for Young function phi, we denote by g phi the set of all phi functions such that this function is almost increasing, and this function is almost decreasing. Note that phi is in G phi implies doubling condition of phi. We investigate the structure of M phi phi generalized Orlitz-Morris space third kind. Note by theta, the set of all measurable functions equivalent to zero on Z. In this paper, we proved the following lemmas for learned non-triviality class generalized Orlitz-Morris space. This lemma showed that the cloud, this generalized or small space is triviality. Okay. For the GP, this lemma shows that if phi in GP, then MPhi generalized Ordo's Mori class non-triviality. Okay, the Wong theorem gives necessary and sufficient conditions for Spanier type boundedness of the operator E rho from MPhi phi 1 to MPsi phi 2. We give the Spanier type and Adams type results for boundedness in the Ordo's Mori space. So let phi psi be Young functions and phi 1 in G phi and phi 2 in G psi. Let rho satisfies 2 and 5 condition. Assume that phi 8 also fulfilled. Then the conditions 20 and 13 are sufficient for the boundedness of E rho from MPhi 1 to weak MPsi phi 2. Moreover, if phi satisfies number 2 condition, then the conditions 12 and 13 are sufficient for the boundedness of E rho from 1 generalized Ordo Mori space to another generalized Ordo Mori space MPsi phi 2 spaces. This is sufficient. Next necessity. Let phi 1 be almost decreasing. Then the condition 14 is necessary for the boundedness of E rho from MPhi 1 generalized Ordo Mori space MPhi phi 1 to weak generalized Ordo Mori space M. This is a mistake. Weak M psi phi 2 and hence M phi phi 1 to M psi phi 2. Next, if we combine necessity and sufficient, we give the following necessity and sufficient conditions about boundedness. Let rho satisfy 2 and 5 conditions. Assume that condition 8 is fulfilled, that phi 1 is almost decreasing, and phi 1 and phi 2 satisfy 12 condition. Assume also the phi 1 and rho satisfy the condition 15. Then the condition 14, is necessary and sufficient for the boundedness of E rho from MPhi phi 1 to a weak MPsi phi 2. Moreover, if phi satisfies Nabla 2 condition, then the condition 14, is necessary and sufficient for the boundedness of E rho from MPhi phi 1 to MPsi phi 2. Note that this theorem in the case G equal Rn was published in this paper published for the TBD 2019 years. Okay. The following theorems about Adams type boundedness gives necessary and sufficient conditions for the boundedness of the operator E rho from MPhi phi to MPsi eta. So let let phi be Young function and let phi little phi in G phi be almost decreasing. Let beta in zero one interval and define eta t the following form phi t power beta and psi t equals phi t 1 over beta first property sufficient let rho satisfies 2 and 5 conditions then the condition 16 is sufficient for the boundedness of E rho from M phi phi to weak M psi eta. Moreover, if phi satisfies nabla 2, then the condition 16 is sufficient for the boundedness of E rho from M phi phi to M psi eta. Next, necessity. The condition 17 is necessary for the boundedness of E rho from M phi phi to weak M psi eta. And for the boundedness of E rho and weak and strong boundedness of M phi phi to M psi eta. For both boundedness, this condition 17 is necessary condition for the boundedness. If we combine necessity and sufficient boundedness, then we get the following necessity and sufficient boundedness conditions. Let rho satisfy 2 and 5 conditions. Assume that phi satisfies the condition 19. Then the condition 17 is necessary and sufficient for the boundedness of E rho from M phi phi to weak M psi eta. Moreover, if phi satisfies nabla 2 conditions, then the condition 17 is necessary and sufficient for the boundedness of E rho from M phi phi to M psi eta. Okay. The following theorem gives necessary and sufficient conditions for spannet type boundedness of the operator M rho from M phi phi 1 to M psi phi 2. Spannet type results. Let phi psi be Young functions and let phi 1 to G phi and phi 2 in G psi. Assume that rho is increasing and that R power minus Q rho R is decreasing. Assume also that the conditions 11 and 12 are satisfied. Then the condition 19 are sufficient for the boundedness of M rho from M phi phi 1 to weak M psi phi 2. Moreover, if phi satisfies nabla 2 condition, then the condition 11 is sufficient for the boundedness of M rho from M phi phi 1 to M psi phi 2. Next about necessity. Let phi 1 be almost decreasing. Then the condition 20 is necessary for the boundedness of M rho from M phi phi 1 to weak M phi mpc phi 2, and hence mv phi 1 to mpc phi 2. Also combined necessity and sufficient condition, we get the following necessity and condition boundedness. Assume that rho is increasing and air power minus q rho air is decreasing. Assume also that the conditions 11 and 12 are satisfied. Let phi 1 and phi 2 almost decreasing. Then the condition 20 is necessity and sufficient for the boundedness of m rho from mp phi 1 to weak mpc phi 2. Moreover, if phi satisfies Nabla 2 condition, then the condition 20 is necessary and sufficient for the boundedness of m rho from mp phi 1 to mpc phi 2. Okay. The following theorem gives a necessary and sufficient condition for Adamstein boundedness of the operator m rho from mv phi to mpc eta. So let phi be a Young function. Let phi be a Young function, and let phi in g phi be almost decreasing. Assume that rho is increasing and that r minus q rho r is decreasing. Let beta in 0, 1 interval, eta t equal phi t power beta and psi t equal phi t 1 over beta. Then the condition 21 is necessary and sufficient for the boundedness of m rho from mv phi to weak mpc eta. Moreover, if phi satisfies Nabla 2 condition, then the condition 21 is necessary and sufficient for the boundedness of m rho from mv phi to mpc eta. Note that also this theorem in the case G in Rn case was proved by the positivity 2019 in this paper. About applications. We also want to apply our boundedness results about integral operator, maximal operator, fractional maximal operator, fractional integral operator, and Calderon's singular integral operators in some multi-type function spaces. For regularity, ellipticity, parabolicity, and hypoellipticity differential equations. In particular, published 2019 year, we show continuity in generalized order small spaces of sublinear integral operators generated by Calderon-Zygmund operator and their commutators with BMO functions. The obtained estimates are used to study global regularity of the solution of the Dirichlet problem for linear or uniformly elliptic operators L with discontinuous coefficients. We show that LU in generalized order small space implies the second order derivatives belong to also in that order small space in phi phi Rn 2. Consider the Dirichlet problem for second order linear equations LU, and U is in Sobolev Sobolev orbits more spaces, and Sobolev orbits spaces. Subject the following conditions. This is elliptic, strong elliptic conditions. The last assumption implies immediately essential bonds of the sufficients are usual. Also, regularity of the data are usual in demo, and f in generalized or small spaces. The following interior estimate we proved. Let U in Sobolev orbits spaces, and L be a linear uniformly elliptic operator with VMO coefficients, such that LU in local in that or small spaces. This phi satisfies delta 2 and nabla 2. And phi satisfying the following condition. Then second derivative DEGU also in generalized or small spaces, but in subspace or subdomains omega power omega and the following estimate is valid, where the constants depends on noun quants and distance omega prime omega and this distance. Main results, let phi be a Young function with phi in satisfies delta 2 and nabla 2 conditions, and L be uniformly elliptic operator satisfying condition H1 and H2 condition. This is sure H1 and H2 conditions. Then for any function f in mphi phi generalized or small space, if in the function phi in generalized or small space, the unique fixed solution of the problem 22 as second derivative in mphi phi. Moreover, the following estimates is valid. This theorems was proved, electronic theorem of differential equation in 2019 years. This is elliptic. And the parabolic case in our application, in the book which accepted in the Journal of Self-Differential Operators and Application Journal, we show continue to and in generalized parabolic orbit mode spaces of sublinear integral operators generated by parabolic Calderon-Zygmund operator and their commutator with VMO coefficients. As a sequence, we obtain a global MVP regularity result for the Cauchy Dirichlet problem for linear uniformly parabolic equations with vanishing mean oscillation. This is parabolic case. And in this time, we also applied our results in boundness of operators on Morita space in Carnot groups for regularity properties in hypoelliptic equations. But in this time, we not finished this work. Thank you very much for your attention.
Well, thank you very much, Vagif, for a very nice talk.
Also, I want to show what about my also another other what applications what about differential equations. I want to show what this works. What this software, what Genesite Morit space, global regularity, what solution non-divergence elliptic equations, and also this software, Genesite Morit regularity parabolic equations. What Gadjev with higher order non-divergent elliptic equation, Vemo coefficients, and we solved also Dirichlet problem in Genesite vexed Morit spaces. And we continue in this direct also in this time. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, we have time for questions. May I ask one general wondering? Vagif?
Please.
Analysis on Carnot group. Is there any specific in the study of Mori Orlich Mori spaces when you do on Carnot group, or the proofs are pretty much similar? Hello, Vagif?
Please.
Can you hear me?
In this time, yes.
Okay. My question is there any specific of studying Mori and Orlich Mori spaces on Carnot group when you extend result for this general case?
What Carnot groups very important for applications. What
yes.
I say what Carnot groups, this is motivated most important model in the general theory of vector fields satisfied Hermander condition. Heisenberg examples, Carnot group, Heisenberg groups, and Heisenberg-Tal groups, and other what groups look. Beautiful monograph Bonfiglioli Lancanelli Uxone. And Carnot groups also find application in the study of strong pseudo convex domains in complex analysis.
Mm-hmm.
In particular, in this time, and I am also work some but not finished with pseudo convex domains in complex analysis. This is very important integral operator, Bergman type operator, and also in
particular. Yes. Okay.
We also, I also know your works with Professor Samko and others in particular.
Yes.
Symmetrical analysis of quantum mechanics, control theory. We also student in this professor Bandarevum. We also continue with control theory problems. Probability theory also with Professor Bandarevum. We won't continue these problems.
Okay.
Diffusion processes, which in my new workplace, mathematics and it.
Okay. Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Vagif. We have a question from Professor Samko.
Okay.
Hello.
Stefan Grigor.
Talk. Let me ask two questions.
Okay.
The first question is more to the background than to the content of the talk. About early Shimori spaces. In case you consider local Mori Ornish space, do you know, is there known characterization of dual space?
Please, I not understand.
Okay. In case you consider Orlich Mori space, local Orlich Mori space.
Do you know
the description of dual space?
What this means?
Двойственное пространство.
Двойственное пространство. Neat things.
Okay. So you mean to say that such a description is not known?
In this time, I don't know. Maybe we discuss next time later.
Okay, very good. And then the second question, well, it's partially a question, partially a suggestion. Instead of Orlich Mori space, let us introduce Orlich Hertz space. And my impression is that results you presented today may be also obtained for such spaces. What do you think?
Orlich Hertz, you say, yes?
Yes, exactly.
Need looking. Look and then maybe.
Yeah. Okay. We can discuss this later.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. We have one more question from Professor Driehem.
Yes. Alex.
Thank you.
So my question.
Excuse me.
Thank you very much for this talk. We have two questions. The first is there is a vector valued case of your results.
Also, we have also vector valued also what in our works with. Savano also other papers we also proved vector valued case also about boundedness our results.
The second is also the weighted version of your results.
Yes, weighted also in this time we about generalized orbits weighted orbits Mori spaces we also characterized maximal operator, fractional maximal operator, fractional integral operator, and singular integral operators in result boundedness generalized orders weighted orders Mori space we will characterize it. We sufficient and necessary condition boundedness.
Thank you.
Professor Lukyanenko, do you have a question?
Hello, can I give a question?
Okay. Miran, okay, go ahead, please.
Okay, first of all, thanks, nice talk, Vagif. Hello, Are you hearing me?
Dada, privet, Miran.
Okay, privet. Nice talk, and I wanted to ask you, what about more generalized Orlich Mori type spaces? To understand when you supremum is changing, we are consider this local Mori type spaces, Orlich house, when supremum we changed by integral. And what is, have you considered such spaces?
what this is show definition of generalized.
Yes, but after this we have considered generalized more type spaces when supremum is changed by. Have you considered or you were planning to consider when supremum is changed by integral or another norm? Because Stepan Grigorovich already asked about about Hertz space. In Hertz space, supremum must be changed by integral, yes?
Maybe.
No, what we have this Mori type spaces, we named this Orlich Mori type spaces. You have not yet considered, I think.
No.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Maybe consider. Okay.
No, thank you. More questions, please.
Alexei, it's possible.
Yes, please go ahead, please.
Vagif, one question. In the analysis in the Heisenberg groups, very important application to so-called sub-elliptic estimates.
Yes.
I think your results take an attention to this very important topic in partial differential equations.
Yes, in this time I am working in this direction, and to my paper in this time in exceptions. I won't say in this my two paper about hypoelliptic differential equations regularity property. Submit and accept it.
Other question. Carnot groups and homogeneous groups, it is the same?
Yes.
It is other title. Carnot
groups. It is the same. Also, added. Differential operator, vector fields. Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you very
much. Very interesting
talk. Thank you. Okay. We have a couple of minutes for one more question, maybe. Okay. Well, very interesting talk. Many questions. And guys, please let's thank Vagif for very nice lecture.
Thank you.